think about this one question posed by Albert Camus quite frequently. In fact, it's all-consuming for me. Camus claims, and I'm paraphrasing here, suicide is the fundamental question in all of philosophy. Whether one ought to live or die, everything else flows from that. Well, that's fucking foreboding and ominous, so thanks, Camus. But you know what's heavier? Is experiencing a tragedy and surviving it. I struggled with whether or not to share this story, but after talking to many people, I reasoned and I rationalized that one, we're gonna break the stigma here, and two, it actually serves a purpose. When I was 19, I was violently raped by a friend of mine. The days, the weeks, the months, the years after, I questioned my purpose. Why was I here? Why did I survive such a horrific experience? There must be some sort of purpose. And I shouted into the void. I couldn't figure out anything. This was made all the more worse when going out into a normal everyday life. I imagine you, after you've experienced a tragedy, you think about purpose as well. Why were you left? Why did you experience that? Needless to say, all of this questioning before the horrendous experience before started when I was a teenager. My poor mother had to deal with me reading Friedrich Nietzsche as a 12-year-old. Also, by this point in time, I had died and been brought back to life. So this propelled me to experience a vast array of things. I became obsessed with finding out what it is that I was meant to do. I was a ballerina, amateur rocket scientist, that's Poindexter right there. I climbed mountains, I traveled every opportunity I got, and I studied philosophy at CU. But none of this brought me any closer to this sense of purpose. What was my raison d'etre? Why was I here? So I started reading Kant. Like you do. In the Critique of Pure Reason, which is like 500 pages of dense metaphysics, Immanuel Kant lays out the foundations of transcendental idealism, which is to basically say the world is such that it conforms to our cognition. Essentially, we're walking around, we're observing and experiencing life, we're inputting that data to our mind, categorizing it, and then outputting a worldview. He says that this is all governed by something called the transcendental aesthetic, which is just a fancy way of saying that space is time simultaneous and time is successive. Essentially, these experiences, these observations that we input and output are marked by a certain point in time and space. Cool, great, we've figured out how the mind works, how we walk around and we categorize our life. That brings me no step closer to figuring out what my purpose is, because really, purpose is something that we rationalize and try to cognize, where we're just placing an objective value on something that refers to a subjective experience. The philosophy of existentialist Jean-Paul Sartre fits in quite well here. Sartre was motivated by one of his teachers, Edmund Husserl, who proclaimed that existence entails essence. Essentially, our experiences make us who we are as people. To me, this is eerily familiar to what Kant said in the Critique. In so much as we walk around, we observe, and we experience, output a worldview. Cool, we figured it out. I still don't know what I'm doing. And I'm still brought back to that question posed by Camus of suicide. Is my life worth living? To be clear, I'm not suicidal. I really enjoy living. I would like to keep doing it. But one of the things that I'm perplexed by is what defines life? And I've concluded that it's our experiences. So here I stand to you, a 28-year-old girl living, for all intents and purposes, a fairly normal life in Boulder, Colorado. But I have no idea what I'm meant to do. But I don't think that's the point. I don't think it's the point to find out what your purpose is. I think at the end of the day, only after we are able to cognize the amalgam of experiences that we have, do we really get that sense of purpose. So I beseech you, I implore you to go out, to experience life to its greatest potential. That's my dog Sage, she's very cute. And to live, to exist, because purpose is not to be defined, purpose is to be experienced.
Thank you.